You know, they're being forced out of their homes tonight in these conditions, evicted because they say their landlord won't fix his crumbling property's problems. And now these tenants want answers, but who's going to help them recover from all of this?
This is Team 4 investigator Paul Van Osdahl walking up to one of Michael Sturdivant's two Penn Hills homes. The tenants he rents to live here.
This, look what we have to do to keep the cool air out.
Inside a Swissvale slum.
You got babies. You got older people. Come on.
This is just a sampling of the citations, and these are the people now evicted.
As a tenant, I feel like we were treated as animals. I feel like he just brought us in here knowing that the conditions were the way that they were, and he was in violation, and he just threw us to the wolves.
Swissvale's fire chief knows this building well.
We've had two fires here within the last 6 months. We had a ceiling fall on a woman.
And tenants live with it.
Outlets broken. He got plaster falling from the walls.
Chief Wilhelm says Sturdivant works the system.
He'll file appeal after appeal and continuance after a continuance.
And puts lives at risk.
As an example, when we file a round of citations, there's $18,000 in fines. And then by the time it's adjudicated, 6-8 months later after the appellate process, it gets reduced to $1,000. And then we have to start all over.
And while Sturdivant's under appeal, he can't be charged for the same violation again. Tonight, his tenants asked for more time to move out, but Chief Wilhelm knows granting it could cost them everything.
It's getting to the point where it's not a matter of if something's going to happen, it's probably when it's going to happen, and we don't want that to occur.
You can see the pain in his face. It's a catch-22 situation. The chief really wants to do something.
Oh, he does, and in fact, normal stipulation is 10 days before you're evicted. Yeah. He's giving them 30 days, but he knows if he gives them even that long, who knows what could happen? There could be a fire, somebody could die.
We're talking about multiple families, too.
Yeah. Tenuous situation there. We'll keep you posted.